The Car Guy Channel. My name is Mike Hennessy.
This show is all about cars and all four car guys.
Get yourself a cold beer.
Get yourself a cold beer, guys, because our show is...
Okay!
We are smoking!
I'm Mike Hennessy, and you're watching the Car Guy Channel. I have an auto repair shop. I've been in the business for over 30 years. You name it, we got it, we built it, we've done it, we do it. We love this car stuff, and I hope you guys do too. We're going to have a lot of fun, got a lot of stuff cooking, so just stay tuned.
Don't let it bother you when things go wrong. If you're glum, just hum and sum, good luck will come along.
Welcome to the Car Guy Channel. We got a show that's absolutely spectacular. Yes, we're again over at History Park at the Antique Auto Show. We got all sorts of things to show you. Their marquee car this year is the Cadillac. They have some Cadillacs, I'm telling you, probably never heard of or never seen, and to be really surprised on seeing the horsepower, the size of the pistons. Hey, we got to wait and show you that the rest of the show. And the other thing is, I went on a barn find. I got a phone call from one of you viewers to go out there and see an early model Hudson. We went out there, pulled the car out of the barn, and to check out a few things. Hey, there's a couple things you don't touch. Don't touch any of these cars. Don't touch that dial. Sit down, get yourself a cold one, because we have a fantastic show. We happen to catch a car driving in. The guy's all the way from Santa Cruz. Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Todd Manoff.
Mike Hennessy. Todd, how you doing?
Nice, great. Nice to meet
Good
you.
Good to see you. And of course, when I caught you getting in, you said you came from Santa Cruz. First thing I said, you drove this from Santa Cruz over to here to San Jose?
No, I trailered it over. I know I'm running a little late, but I didn't want to be that late.
You did what any smart vintage car owner would do. You drove it from that distance from the parking lot to here.
Yeah, well, it's got a, you know, about a top speed of 30 if you're pushing it. So yeah.
Downhill, good wind.
That's right.
Downhill, good
and
wind.
No hills.
And no hills. And I was talking to Lucy earlier, and she goes, Mike, that's our poster car. That's pretty cool, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
I think it's really cool. Now, what year is it?
A 1906, Model M.
Now, Model M. Now, any history about this car, anything special?
Well, the car has been in the Santa Cruz area for a number of years. It was originally restored in the late 50s, early 60s by a fellow in Palo Alto that collected cars. And then it moved around a couple spots, but it's been in a collection for many years now, and I purchased it from those folks.
That's pretty cool. A single cylinder?
Yep, one cylinder.
And that was the bore like 5 inches round?
Yeah, it's a 5x5.
5x5. We were talking about earlier. Look at the piston. I mean, that's incredible. And this thing just like a one-lunger, you know, just moves
yeah,
and moves.
You have a compression release to crank it over the compression.
Oh, you would have to, without a doubt. Now, how long have you had it?
I've had it about 6 years.
Oh, man, getting into it. You always been a vintage car guy, or is this your first one?
No. I've got about 10 other cars. So
oh, you do? Good. So guys like him and I, we're normal. We're really normal. My way, I have a lot of cars myself. I have to tell Susan, there's a lot of guys out there. That's why I do the Car Guy Channel show, to prove to her there's guys like you and me out there that have these things. Good.
Somebody's got to save this these wonderful pieces of history.
Oh, without a doubt. Now, is this your first time at Kelly Park? Or?
No, this is my probably second or third time I've been here.
Nice show. A nice event.
Yeah, nice event.
One of my favorite Cadillacs that is displayed here today happens to be this 1911. Now, you're going to see a couple beautiful ones. Ruby, a beautiful restored car, but a 1911 Cadillac here. It's called a Model 30. Now, this is a four-cylinder engine, and that kind of boosted up things a little bit. And they had a 4.5-inch bore and four cylinders, and it was 4.5-inch stroke on the cylinders, going up and down 4.5 inches. But what really, really intrigued me about this car has the 10-spoke wood wheels. Now, these wheels were all real wood, but you can tell these are real wood. They're not painted, they're not, you know, fluffed up in any way at all. But this car right here, to me, looks like the Survivor class. You can tell there's some restoration work done on it, probably in the past, many years back. But you can tell this car here gets driven on the road, it does get used and abused like cars need to. And Cadillac was such a well-built car back then. Cadillac was in the same category, really, as your Rolls-Royce and other grand marvels of cars. So Cadillac really was a top piece. I want you to look this car here over, and you're going to be able to see, and I'll point out some issues. This car here is meant to drive. You can see things in this car here that looks like restoration is going to be in the need really soon, but this just shows you the patina on this car here. This is the original lacquer paint that's actually coming off the wood. Yes, I said wood. A lot of these bodies were a lot of wood. The fenders, you can see that they are a steel, they were a tin style material, metal, and they're all tin that's metal. So you go ahead and you got wood that's underneath, and actually some things they laid.
Everybody had an ocean across the USA, and everybody be surfing by California. You
see them wear their baggies, Hirachi sandals too. Bushy, bushy blonde hairdo, Surfing USA. You catch them surfing at Delmar, Missouri County Line,
inside,
Santa Cruz and Trestle,
outside,
in the Caribbean,
inside, USA.
All over Manhattan,
inside, USA.
Down the Heaney Way,
inside, everybody's gone surfing.
Welcome to the Car Guy Channel. We got a fantastic show this week. We're covering Dream Machines from one end to the other, and we got all sorts of hot rods, high ones, low ones, fast ones, and we got them all. We got grills going. I got the gals with me today. We got a full pack day going on down here at Dream Machines. Two things you don't do. Hey, don't touch any of these cards, and don't touch that dial. Sit back, get yourself a cold one, because we're going to be rocking and rolling.
Surfing USA. Tiger knees and swans, Pacific Palisades, San Onofre and Suns, Redondo Beach, L.A., all over La Jolla, Wyoming,
everybody's got
the cool thing about setting our booth up over here at Dream Machines, we get a lot of neighbors, and this is one of our neighbors. Introduce yourself.
I'm Sally Haig. I'm from Livermore, California.
Hi, Sally. Sally's across from us. They got the barbecue going, and the thing is, she's got a pretty cool car, and tell us a little bit about it.
I got it for Christmas one year. I'd seen it 2 years before at our own car show in downtown Livermore, and I told my husband that was the fat fendered Ford convertible I wanted, and we couldn't get the owner to come to a term.
Your husband couldn't make him an offer he couldn't refuse, huh?
Well, we went to a Christmas party 2 years later, and as we pull into our friend's little cul-de-sac, there's this purple gleaming car, and I said, there's my car! And he said, what do you mean your car? I said, if you let somebody else buy this car, you are dead meat. And it was mine.
Guys, we know how that's all about. And what's the year of the car?
It's 46.
46, and what kind of motor?
Do I have to say on the air?
No one's going to know.
It's another make. It's a 350, and you fill in the blank.
It's okay. 350 Chevy motors mounted them real well. It's about dependability, durability. When I build cars at my shop, we're about safety. And so it's an easy motor to put together and a safe engine.
Yeah.
And so you really enjoy this car.
I do. I wanted to get in and turn the key and have it go. And it's got power steering. Santa brought that about 3 years ago to me. So I've owned the car for, I think, 17 years now. So it just keeps getting better.
That Santa's been pretty darn good.
Yes.
Hey, we're going to check this car out. Estelle's going to go over the cab rod and just check out one of our neighbor's cars. Besides all the cars we have here at Dream Machines, there's a lot of facets that make this event work. And one of the big facets here is my good buddy Mark Fanichel. Mark, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Thanks, Mike. Thanks for talking today.
Oh, what an event. I saw you on stage earlier. Now, Ben, you're telling me this guy here, he's really the real deal, right?
Yeah, this is Mark Hummel and Rusty Zinn. Those guys have played with everybody you can imagine in the blues world. Mark Hummel also puts together an incredible show every year of harmonica players from all over, including guys like Magic Dick.
But when you come here and you see the cars, you see these wild trucks going on, this is a real exciting event.
This really is. We've been here 25 years doing the show, and there's so many things to see and so much to do. Not only cars, you got airplanes and tractors and steam engines and donkey mules.
And it goes on and on. It's crazy. We got a lot more stuff to see here down here at Dream Machines. Stick around!
My name is Mark Fanichel with Pacific Coast Dream Machines and Miramar Events, and you're watching the Car Guy Channel.
Why do fools fall in love? Why do birds sing so gay? Lovers await the break of day. Why do they fall in love?
You gotta love an early model Chevrolet Nova. What I really respected about this car here, this car is still a six-cylinder.
A little this coupe, you don't know what I got. Well, I'm not bragging, babe, so don't put me down. Cause I've got the
Welcome to the Car Guy Channel. We got a fantastic show. We're covering the Mountain View a la carte and art show. We got cars from high ones, fast ones, slow ones, expensive ones. We got cool stuff all day long. And to see some of the cars we had kind of last year, some of the people come and pick up, and we got some newbies coming to the show this year too. Got a lot of cool stuff to show you guys. So I want you to do two things. Don't touch that dial. Don't touch any of these cars. Check them out.
You don't know what I got.
I'm going to tell you guys, this is not Mom and Dad's old station wagon, is it?
Nope.
How you doing, Mike?
All right, Jeff Peterson.
Hey, Jeff,
nice
thanks for coming on the show. Nice to meet you. Hey, tell me a little bit about the 70 monster wagon you got.
Okay, I picked it up in 1999. It's a 16-year restoration. I went through the whole car, motor, tranny, rear end, paint, everything. Except the interior I left original because it was in pretty good shape.
Right? Wagons are good investments.
Yeah, yeah.
And you can buy them, right?
Right, right. I only paid $900 for it back in 99.
Now, that's a hell of an investment, I'll tell you right now. That's pretty good stuff. So you can put the V8 in, and this thing sounded like a pretty nasty little motor.
Yeah. It's got gear drive. It's got a steel crank. It's got Vortec heads. Four barrel. It's a driver.
One thing that I noticed, this car has black interior.
Yeah, that's pretty rare for a wagon to have black interior because most of the wagons, they had color matched, same color as the cars.
Now, on the I'm not a wagon expert. I have a few in my collection, but this is a Greenbrier, correct?
Right, yeah. There weren't too many Greenbriers out there because it was a stripped model. It didn't come with a roof rack, nothing. Just your base wagon.
That was Ward Cleaver on a cheap day, went for the Greenbrier. I always pick a car at these events that happen to be one of my favorites, and it happens to be this old 442. How you doing there, bud?
I'm doing great. How are you today?
Good. Good to see you. Thank you for bringing this Hearst car.
You're welcome.
Now, do you know what old 442 stands for?
Four-barrel, 400, and dual exhaust.
Ah, you're good. You're good. You're good. How many were made?
624.
How many coupes?
222 with the sunroof. 110 were convertibles, and the balance were just the hard tops. I can't do the math fast enough. So.
That's pretty good. This is the Car Guy Channel. Trust me, no one on the show really does a lot of hard math at all. And I noticed you have some parts in this car. You have a lot of the real deal stuff. I was mostly impressed, really, with the air cleaner.
Yes, it's the original flapper air cleaner that goes with the hood for the Ram Air.
Sure, exactly. Now, that's a huge deal. Mm-hmm. And you got the right hood pins. Now, was this car true and correct?
This car was absolutely true and correct. It was a one-owner car. The guy actually bought it from Marydale Oldsmobile here in San Jose.
Now, how much of this car is really original and how much is restored?
This car is pretty much a survivor. It's everything you see in it is original. It's getting to the point now where I am going to have to start replacing some things.
Well, I have a statement. I say it on the show all the time. A car is only original once.
That's right.
And the longer you can keep this car here with the patina and the way this car is, I'm going to encourage you. And we'll get cards and letters. Guys, let them know. We kind of encourage you to go that avenue if you can. Keep it, because it looks like you keep the car garage capped while you're taken care of and all that stuff.
Absolutely. Garaged. Only driven to car shows.
Now, big question. How long have you had this car?
I've had this car for about a year and a half.
Now, a year and a half. You're a newbie.
Yes.
What drew you to the Olds Hearst car? Was it, now you could have gotten Olds 442, you could have went to a different lead, you could have street rodded. What went for the Hearst car? Is it the white and gold?
The white and gold and the rareness of the car, and you just don't see that many of them anymore.
Oh, and they're difficult to restore because, again, how many people, when there's only 200-something of the breed built, especially in the sunroof, that's the part that attracted me on your car was the sunroof.
Oh, sunroof, yes.
Oh, I think it's cool. Hey, thanks for being on the show.
Thank you.
Olds 442 had a lot of interesting tidbits about them, but one thing I really liked, it was a lot of neat little classy touches, and that's the detail. When you get detail to a car, people have done it to a lot of Pontiacs and other makes and models of cars, and you can go ahead and do this on your own street rod or whatnot to give it the actual 442 effect. But on the back of the bumpers, they actually cut the bumpers, kind of a little bit of a half moon, that the rear tail exhaust kind of comes up into the bottom of it. I think it's fantastic. It's kind of one of the rarest cars here today at the show, and I was pretty impressed with an Olds 442, especially a Hearst model, being white with the gold stripes. You just don't see them every day, and you know how that is on the Car Guy Channel. You get something rare, you don't see it every day, we got to show it to you.
Went to a dance, looking for